Epcot's Food and Wine Festival has begun. Fantasmic is returning to Disneyland, but not when you think. Magic Kingdom is getting a search and sniff adventure. Yeah, we've got lots of questions too. And loads of new snacks are headed to the parks. Let's get you all caught up on the Disney news from this week. Hey everybody, it's AJ for Disney Food Blog. It's been a busy week for us here at DFB. We're all still probably exhausted from that opening day of Food and Wine. And we've still got plenty of other news to share with you this week though, including that bizarre new scent-based attraction Disney is cooking up. So let's get started. It's time for another Epcot Festival. The Epcot 2023 International Food and Wine Festival kicked off on Thursday, July 27th, and will run through November 18th. With over 25 festival food booths opened right now, and more on the way later in August and September, there is a lot of food to choose from, and luckily, we're going to make things easy for you. We have full reviews of every single dish at the festival up on DisneyFoodBlog.com right now. Our Best of the Fest video will be up on the channel very soon, and we've got our jam-packed DFB guide to the Epcot Food and Wine Festival available for sale over at DFBstore.com. Now, our festival guide is going to make you an expert in no time with full reviews and color photos of the dishes at this year's festival. All the info on festival extras like scavenger hunts and those Eat to the Beat concerts and everything else. If you want a quick cheat sheet for the fest, we've got our updated map and food checklists, and you can grab those for free at DisneyFoodBlog.com/foodwinemap or just scan the QR code. Disneyland's nighttime show Fantasmic has been closed since late April when the large Maleficent dragon caught fire during a performance, and Disneyland has now announced that Fantasmic will return in spring 2024. When the show returns, it will not include the Maleficent dragon figure, but will feature new special effects and a thrilling new battle scene between Sorcerer Mickey and Maleficent. In the meantime, you can see Queenie and the Jambalaya Jazz Band perform high-energy tunes and Disney favorites as they float down the rivers of America on a New Orleans-themed raft. Disney plans to announce more entertainment coming to the Rivers of America soon. So Disney Parks announced on Twitter that a new interactive experience is coming to Magic Kingdom. It's called Smell-O-Fants on Parade, and it's going to be a family-friendly search-and-sniff adventure in Storybook Circus. It's presented by Scentsy, and Disney noted that they'll be sharing more details in the future. Based on the concept art, looks like we'll be getting an elephant statue shaped like popcorn. We're not really sure what's going on here, to be honest. Whatever's going on, Disney certainly got our attention with that name and concept art, so we're intrigued and we're ready to learn more so we can make sense of all this. Get it? Oh, ouch. Back in September of 2022, Disney announced that the iconic Hatbox Ghost would be making his way over to Disney World's version of the Haunted Mansion ride. Now, we've learned that later this year, Hatbox Ghost will pop up in the Haunted Mansion, specifically as guests pass the Endless Hallway. So that's kind of right where you come out of the hallway where the coffin is. It's right before the clock, and it's where the hidden Donald chair is, and the suit of armor, and the hallway where you see like the floating candelabra. Okay, was that helpful? Okay, good. Now, what's interesting is that the Hatbox Ghost's location in Disney World is going to differ from his location in Disneyland. Disney said that guests will soon see temporary barriers materialize as we wait for the Hatbox Ghost to arrive. And for those who aren't sure where he is in Disneyland, he's right after the attic scene, right before you kind of tilt backwards and go down into the graveyard. Disney released some new photos showing off what the new cast member outfits look like for those who will be working with the new Journey of Water attraction, that Moana attraction in Epcot. There are some Moana-inspired wave details on each sleeve that can be rolled up and buttoned. We've seen a lot of work going on in this area of the park, and the attraction is expected to open fall of 2023. Trails End Restaurant over at Fort Wilderness has finally reopened. In the past, the restaurant served family-style skillets for breakfast and dinner, but closed in February in anticipation of an overhaul. The new setup is a quick-service restaurant featuring a pizza station, burgers, sandwiches, barbecue fare, and more. Crockett's Tavern, just next door, has also received a refresh and a menu upgrade and will now operate as a lounge. Full reviews for both locations will be up on the site very, very soon. Disney California Adventure's San Francisco transition is well underway, and now we've got some new snacks to try. The Cerveceria is officially open, where you can grab a cold beer and garlic pinwheel chips mix. Cocina Cucamonga Mexican Grill is also now serving San Francisco-style street corn, and Rita's Turbine Blenders has new icy drinks. We've still got another month until San Francisco officially opens, but you can already check out all of these new items, and we'll have full reviews up on the site. Starting this fall, three more Disneyland restaurants will be offering alcoholic beverages in the previously completely dry park. Up until now, only Blue Bayou and Oga's Cantina served alcoholic beverages in Disneyland Park, besides Club 33 and Salon Nouveau. But beginning September 12th, Carnation Cafe, Riverbell Terrace, and Cafe Orleans will serve alcohol as well. This includes a Wildberry Mule at Riverbell Terrace, Pim's Hurricane at Cafe Orleans, a Peach Pie Margarita at Carnation Cafe, along with Bloody Marys and mimosas at breakfast. There are currently no plans for any quick service restaurants to begin serving alcohol in the park, so it will work like Magic Kingdom at this point, where you can only get those alcoholic drinks at table service restaurants. Tiana's Palace is currently under construction and set to open at Disneyland Park later in 2023, but a brand new sign and smokestack decor have been added to the front of the restaurant. Things are progressing quickly, but we still do not have an opening date for this new restaurant yet. Halloween season at Disney is fast approaching. We've got the list of all the snacks coming to Magic Kingdom this year. I believe there are 30 of them coming. An apple fritter milkshake is coming to Anti-Gravity's, a mummy pastry to Cheshire Cafe, a spicy chicken sandwich and spicy meatball sub, plus a very green dessert and drink at Cosmic Rays, a buffalo chicken hand pie and new loaded tots at Friar's Nook, a very cute tombstone tart at Westward Ho. You got a Cajun burger on a black bun at Pecos Bill, char siu wings at Sleepy Hollow, a new Hades-themed cone at Storybook Treats, a black velvet whoopie pie at Liberty Square Market, and a whole bunch more. Many of these are only available during Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party, the extra ticketed after-hours event in the park. We're going to be there opening night with live coverage on the site and a full review video shortly after, so follow along with us so you know which snacks are a win and which snacks you can skip. And maybe save your teeth from all that black and green food dye. World Princess Week is returning to the Disney parks this August, and they're celebrating that week for a whole month with new snacks. Several new treats featuring Moana, Ariel, Aurora, and Rapunzel will hit the parks and resorts starting August 1st. We're also seeing a few returning snacks that we tried last year, like the Snow White and Cinderella cupcakes at Old Key West and Contemporary Resorts. Most of these will be available the whole month of August, though some, like the Rapunzel Sundae in Magic Kingdom, are available now. Disneyland will see a few new treats, including the purple pineapple shell macaron coming to Edelweiss Snacks. And international parks are going to see some new additions. Tokyo Disney might be winning with their Beauty and the Beast popcorn bucket. Stay tuned to the channel for some reviews. It's tacho time at Disney's Value Resorts. The Loaded Tacho Bowl is a breakfast bowl with potato barrels topped with scrambled eggs, cheddar, sausage gravy, and bacon, and it's now available at the Value Resort food courts, including the All-Star Resorts, Art of Animation, and Pop Century. Everything in our bowl was very fresh, the gravy was a bit mild, but overall very tasty. It's $10.99, and it's a very filling breakfast. Florida residents can get some great discounts at two Disney Springs restaurants right now. Paddlefish and Terralina Crafted Italian are offering a 25% discount to Florida residents through August. The deal is good Monday through Friday. If you're not a Florida resident, Paddlefish is also offering a $35 lunch special that includes a choice of salad, entree, and cocktail, beer, or soft drink available Monday through Fridays from 11:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. A few new floats have popped up at Gelateria Toscana in Epcot's Italy Pavilion. There are two new alcoholic floats on the menu, the Bronte, made of Fabrizia pistachio-flavored liqueur with a scoop of creamy pistachio gelato for $19. The gelato was super creamy and didn't taste overly pistachio-flavored, but had more texture with the nuts rolled into the scoop. The liquor also gave a slight pistachio taste, but wasn't overly assertive or overpowering. Next up, the Amalfi, made with Fabrizia limoncello liqueur with a scoop of homemade limoncello raspberry gelato. This drink packs a strong limoncello flavor. It's a bit more refreshing and it's stronger than the pistachio float. These are on the pricier side, but they're unique and tasty. Magic Kingdom is celebrating the release of the Haunted Mansion movie with even more snacks in the park. We got a peanut butter and jelly push pop with a chocolate tombstone that can be found at Sleepy Hollow Refreshments. Disney's also serving up the Happy Haunts shake at Columbia Harbor House. We've seen this purple donut top shake before. At Disney's Port Orleans Resort French Quarter, you'll be able to find the Mickey-shaped caretaker beignets, which are dusted with cookies and cream powdered sugar, and a ghoulish marshmallow cream drizzle. And the Playful Spirits Margarita featuring Patron Silver Tequila with the Fess Parker Big Easy Red Floater that's also available over there at Scat Cats Club and Cafe. These are only around for a limited time, so seek them out soon if you want to try any of these new snacks. We have tried the beignets, the push pop. We had that Happy Haunts shake a long time ago. Margarita was not available. We went over there today to try it, so we're going to try that another time, but definitely look for reviews on the blog. I think the beignets were really, really good. The Black Forest Baumkuchen, that German multi-layer cake, has snuck into Connections Cafe. You gotta be in the know to get it, though. You will only find this cake on mobile order right now, or by asking a cast member about it specifically. This one will only be available during the Epcot Food and Wine Festival, so it's kind of a festival bonus. Riviera Resort has some new merch this week. The Riviera Resort mini ears have sparkly blue ears and a postcard-inspired bow with the Riviera Resort logo in the middle of the bow, and they're $44.99. There's also a new Loungefly backpack in a matching print, and the Riviera Resort Loungefly mini backpack has the same blue ears, but the postcard design of the bow covers the whole bag and features Mickey, Minnie, Donald, and Daisy on the front. You can grab that one for $75. Halloween season merch is starting to arrive in the parks en masse, including some new Hocus Pocus ears. The back is covered in stars along with the Hocus Pocus logo with a spooky skeleton bow on the front. They're a velvet material and the interior is an orangey peach color. We also spotted a new Hocus Pocus spirit jersey and a concert poster style tee. So far, we've only seen these items inside Island Mercantile at Disney's Animal Kingdom, but we expect to see it elsewhere soon, along with even more merchandise from this particular collection. Plus, we're seeing lots of other Halloween merch start to drop in Disney World, including these wildly fluffy bat ears with a vampire mini on them, a bright jack-o'-lantern Mickey Loungefly bag, and some new Haunted Mansion merch as well. Disneyland is selling a new popcorn bucket to celebrate the 100-year anniversary of the company. The Disney 100 Mickey Train Bucket has arrived to popcorn carts around the park, but it's only going to be available for a limited time. It comes with popcorn storage, Mickey Mouse as a conductor, and even a little pull-out train whistle. Another new souvenir item has arrived in Disneyland. The spooky light-up hat box ghost sipper can be found at carts around New Orleans Square and Critter Country. He's $32. So there's the news for this week, everybody. If you want to get the news every single day in your inbox for free, you can do that. Head over to our description down there and click the link to sign up for our newsletter. Again, it's totally free, and you'll be able to see everything that's happened each day in the Disney parks and around the Disney World every morning, along with a link to watch our video for the day as well. And also don't forget to head over to dfbstore.com, pick up those guidebooks, and get ready to plan for your Disney World vacation. Thanks for listening, everybody, and thanks for watching. As always, this is AJ for Disney Food Blog, and we'll see you real soon.